Hello and welcome back. Today we're moving on with our ancient Iberian series by talking about the Iberians, the Aquitanians, and the Vascones. The Iberians, Aquitanians, and the Vascones were civilizations living in eastern Iberia, and they all share pre-Indo-European ancestry. There are many reasons to believe that these people all had common ancestors because their culture is almost identical. They were able to split and to make a name for themselves only after many centuries. And the Aquitanians and the Vascones in particular were basically the same people, but they got different names due to their different relations they had with Rome. The Aquitanians lived north of the Pyrenees and were defeated and annexed by Rome during Julius Caesar's Gallic campaign in 56 BC. The Vascones, on the other hand, came to an agreement with Rome that gave them significant independence and structural advantages over their neighbors. Romans used Vascones territory to get quick access to Iberia from Gaul, and they surely appreciated the Vascones as allies. The Vascones in return got very little colonizations or attempts of integrations from the Romans during the Republican times, as well as roads and special Roman trade deals made their economy flourish. The Aquitanians are seen as the ancestors of the French Basque, and the Vascones are seen as the ancestors of the Spanish Basques. Today the Basques are one unique cultural group in Europe, one of the only ones claiming to have a pre-Indo-European ancestry. The Iberians also had a lot to share culturally with the northern neighbors, except that they also adopted many costumes and resources from Greeks and Phoenicians that they had met through trade. Especially the field of art and pottery took a lot of influence from the Greek one. When both the Phoenicians and the Greeks started to settle in the area, the Iberians became more and more westernized, and by the 4th century, they had developed a more advanced social structure based on clientelism, just like in Rome. After the First Punic War, the Carthaginians expanded their reach on the Iberian territory, and southeast Spain became the stage of many battles during the Second Punic War, which brought the Iberians being first defeated by the Carthaginians and being enrolled to fight against Rome, just to be defeated and be taken care by Rome for centuries to come. Iberia was named Hispania, and they all eventually got absorbed into Roman culture. But wait, there is more. I would like to say more about their culture and what made the Iberians stand out. Just like the Celtiberians, many of the major Iberian settlements were too oppidus, except that they were more western looking, originated a century before, and were not as impenetrable. Just like with the Turdetani, Phoenician gods played a huge role in the Iberian pantheon. The only difference is that the Greek ones as well were just as important to them. Iberians also practiced many religious rites, often in caves, hosted by their own druids, and animal sacrifices were very common. What we know also a lot about is the way they buried their dead and their view on the afterlife. Bodies were buried together with their belongings after being incinerated and put into fancy vases. Death was seen as the starting point of a journey, which was symbolized by a crossing of the sea, the land, or even the sky. Supernatural and mythological beings, such as the Sphinx or the Wolf, accompanied the guide and guided the deceased on their journeys. The wolf in particular was seen as a mystical animal looking after humans for the gods. Many forms of art, such as sculpture and painting, were heavily influenced by Greece and to some extent even Egypt, making Iberia quite the diverse environment for ancient artists in need of inspiration. Finally, we also know a lot about warfare, which, unlike the other fields we have previously discussed, it's very unique. Ancient sources mention two major types of Iberian infantry, the Scutati and the Caetrati. Scutati were heavily armored and carried large Celtic-type scutum shields, The Caedrati carried the caedra, a small Iberian buckler. Iberians are commonly associated with curved swords called the falcata, but they also used spears and javelins. Iberians often used hit-and-run tactics and were particularly good at ambushing. Iberian horsemen were particularly good at doing hit-and-runs, and the Iberian horses were considered the best in the Mediterranean for a very long time. That will be all I can say about the Iberians, Aquitanians, and Vascones. I hope you found this video interesting, and I hope you will follow me next time too in a brand new video. Cheers!